What is up, Sexy Beast? Crazy Rabbit here, and today we're going to be doing the top 5 worst power-ups to have on high rounds. Now, this is strictly my opinion and not yours. You might have a completely different list, which is totally fine. And also, for the footage for this video, you might have to use your imagination for some parts, because it's kind of hard to get a specific power-up on high rounds, so do your best. So taking number 5 spot is going to be Zombie Blood. Now hold your horses, because I already know a lot of people are going to be like, what the fuck are you talking about? Zombie Blood is extremely useful. Yes, it is on early rounds. Like, once you're completely set up, you don't really need Zombie Blood. In case you don't know what Zombie Blood does, it's basically like a zombie repellent. You kind of turn into a zombie and all the zombies run away from you. And if your goal is to get to high rounds, you really don't want that, because once you get to high rounds, you're going to be set up, so you're really not going to have to go run around the map or anything. And really, all you kind of want is just the zombies to keep coming in so that way you can keep killing them. You don't want the zombies to run away and kind of get all spread out. You want to keep running your strategy, whether that be you camping in a corner or actually like cycling around a certain area or rape training, whatever you want to call it. So you really don't want the zombies to kind of be running away from you. You want them to be coming towards you so that way you can kill them and progress the rounds faster and faster. Whenever I'm going to high rounds and I get a zombie blood, I get kind of pissed off, because that's like a solid, I believe, like 30 seconds of wasted time, because the zombies are going to run away from me and I basically just sit there with my thumb up my ass because I can't do anything for 30 seconds. So that's why I really dislike having zombie blood on high rounds. It's not the worst. Sometimes it can be kind of useful, like if you're about to get cornered and you happen to get one, or if the boss zombie spawns in and you get one, you can easily take him out. There are certain circumstances which it can be useful, but majority of the time, I never grab zombie blood on high rounds. So taking number 4 spot is going to be the Fire Sail. So the Fire Sail is kind of pointless on high rounds. Yeah, it's pretty good on early rounds, similar with like a lot of other drops, but you're really probably not going to be hitting the box on high rounds. You're never going to need this, unless you're like me and spend 50 fucking rounds trying to get the goddamn Ray Gun Mark II, but the box won't give it to you, then you might want a Fire Sail. But majority of the time, you're probably not going to need a Fire Sail, because I would say by the time you get to the 20s and 30s, you're probably going to be completely set up, unless the box is a huge douchebag. But I would say like 9 times out of 10, if you're not me, you're going to be set up, and Fire Sails are just going to be pointless. You're never going to go and run to the box during the middle of a round once you're on high rounds. It's extremely risky and extremely dangerous. Fire Sails are great to have on early rounds. They help you get set up, but once you get up there, they're just absolutely pointless. And honestly, in my opinion, they're going to cause you more death than good on high rounds, because once you get that Fire Sail, like, your brain is immediately like, go to the box. You could be completely set up, but for some reason your brain is like dumbass and it's like, hey, we might need something in there. There are goodies in the box. It is random. It's like the lottery. It's a drug. You don't go hit the box during the middle of a round. It's extremely dangerous, and that's why I think Fire Sails are kind of pointless. But like I said previously, sometimes it just takes a really long time to get a Wonder Weapon, and if you are struggling to get the Wonder Weapon, even on high rounds, you see a Fire Sail, sometimes you might have to actually go and hit it just to get that Wonder Weapon, so that's why it's at number 4. Alright, and taking number 3 spot is going to be Double Points. So, like every other drop, Double Points is fantastic on early rounds. You want to get as many as you possibly can just because you get set up faster, but like once you get past round 20, Double Points is just really something you don't even bother. Like, if you see it, you'll grab it just to grab it, but you really don't need it just because there's so many zombies coming in that you're going to have more than enough points. Now, similar with the Fire Sail, sometimes the box is a cunt, and sometimes it won't give you what you need. So you're going to need more points, so sometimes on high rounds, you're probably going to need double points. But I would say, like, once you definitely get past round 30, there's just going to be so many zombies coming in, and you'll probably be point hoarding for days that you really won't need a double points, and especially on, like, round 50 plus, there's going to be absolutely no reason to get a double points unless you have literally been wasting every single point you have on the box or gobblegum. Then you might want a double points, but still, there's just going to be so many zombies spawning in that you'll easily be able to make up whatever points you lost. So that's why I think double points is pretty useless. It doesn't really negatively affect you like number 2 and number 1 do, but there really isn't any positive sides of it like zombie blood and Fire Sail on high rounds. Like, double points is kind of just useless. Alright, and taking number 2 spot is going to be the Carpenter. So the Carpenter, in my opinion, is definitely one of the shittiest drops, like, period. Even on early rounds, the only real reason I get it is just because you get, like, that free, I think it's like 200 points or something like that. But, like, once I get up to a certain point where I really don't need 200 points, I try to avoid it at all costs. The main reason for that is, when you're running a strategy to get to high rounds, you want the zombies to spawn in as fast as possible. You really don't want them to be kind of sporadic and, like, have, like, 2 zombies spawning in over here, 15 over there, 4 over here, something like that. You want them to all kind of just flow in at the same time, and you really don't want to be rebuilding barriers because that's kind of going to throw off their spawn, and that's why I hate Carpenters. Whenever I'm going to high rounds, I always make sure that the windows are open so that way the zombies can flood in. And whenever I get a carpenter, it always seems to fuck up the zombie spawns. The zombies will be spawning in at one area faster than another, and it kind of just fucks up my entire strategy. So that's why I absolutely hate carpenters on high rounds. It's just going to fuck up your strategy, it's going to mess with the zombie spawns, and until the zombies break down every single barrier again, it might get a little chaotic and hectic, and you might have to go into MLG mode to actually survive. So that's why I hate carpenters. It fucks up the zombie spawns on high rounds, and it's just absolute terrible drop. Unless you're doing like a challenge maybe, or you just really need those couple hundred points, I would just never grab a carpenter, even on early rounds. It's just not worth it in my opinion. I would rather have the zombies spawn in as fast as possible so I can kill them as fast as possible and not really come in sporadically and all over the place. Alright, so taking the number one spot is going to be the most useless fucking drop in zombies history, and that is the Black Ops 1 Death Machine. This Death Machine fucking sucks so much ass. The Black Ops 1 Death Machine is garbage. It starts pooping out like in the teens to 20s, and then after that, if you don't go for headshots, you'll be lucky to get like a couple kills. This thing really does suck. Like on round 50, the Black Ops 3 Death Machine is absolutely amazing. It's going to tear ass. It's going to be able to tear a lot of ass, like all of the ass. But the Black Ops 1 Death Machine on high rounds sucks so much dick. And the worst part about it is, you can't swap out of it. It takes a couple seconds to actually pull it out, and you run so slow. It's just asking for death whenever you grab this thing. Like, after round 15, if I see this Death Machine drop, I make sure I avoid it at all costs, because I know if I grab that, I'm more than likely gonna die. It doesn't put out enough power, you run super, super slow, and it takes 20 years to actually pull the damn thing out. So the Death Machine, kinda ironically, is just asking for death. Do not grab this thing on high rounds, you will severely regret it. I can't tell you how many times I have died just because I accidentally pick up a Death Machine and I'm like, okay, now I'm fucked. There goes my wonder weapon, and now I have this piece of shit. So the Black Ops 1 Death Machine, in my opinion, is the worst drop to have on high rounds. It's really just gonna kill you more often than really anything. It sucks against zombies, it sucks against boss zombies. It's just an absolute terrible thing to have. So I'm very curious to know, what is your guys' top 5? Let me know in the comments, and if you guys good, please leave a like and subscribe if you have not already. Peace.